can I just say how pleasing it is and what an honour it is to be here at this World Indigenous Network Conference in Darwin with over 50 countries represented. It's an enormous honour for the Northern Territory, but particularly Darwin, to host this event. We're doing some important things today, and one of the most important is we're announcing an extension of the Dhimurru IPA, Indigenous Protected Area, to include 400,000 hectares of sea country going 40 kilometres offshore. That's an enormous thing to do, and it will what it will mean is there'll be a collaboration between Dhimurru and all the agencies and interest groups who are involved in on that water. So commercial fishers, recreational fishers, Commonwealth government agencies, customs, the Defence Force, Northern Territory Department of Fisheries, tourism operators and the like. And they'll each come to the table to work out how to manage that area. But it'll be under the real control, if you like, in terms of the management structure of Dhimurru. And it's an enormous thing to happen. And I want to congratulate Dhimurru because they have been at the forefront of addressing this issue of sea country and control of seas for a hell of a long time. And this initiative is very important to all of us. But what it also says to us is the importance of Aboriginal and Torres Strait Islander rangers here in Australia, and indeed rangers across the world. We now have 700 rangers working across this country, great country of ours, 230-odd here in the Northern Territory, and they do very, very important work. And I don't think it's well known or well understood in the broader community what an important role they play in helping us manage, oversight and care for the sea and country, which is their traditional land and seas. So it's a very, very important day for us, and I'm very, very proud to be here. I'm now going to ask a young man, Wurrunga, who's going to talk to us from the Dhimurru side about this great announcement we're making today.
Hello, I'm Wurrunga Marika, and I'm very pleased to stand here and let you know that this is very important moment for Dhimurru to be a part of the IPA winning, and thank you that it will benefit my people and the children coming after and the next generation. Thank you.
We've got IPAs right across the Northern Territory, and we've got ranger groups operating and looking after sea country, but this is the first which has given us such a huge expanse of water for the local Aboriginal, in this case Aboriginal people, to maintain and look after. And it's a huge tribute to these guys. The Yolngu people of Northeast Arnhem Land have historically had this very, very strong cultural and traditional relationship with the seas, as have Indigenous peoples right across the Australian coastline. And here we've got, I think, the harbinger of things to come as other people see the opportunities that exist and helping to manage that sea country for all Australians. Well, there are already employment opportunities involved here, and clearly the additional ranges which the Commonwealth Government has put in place were part of that scheme. But it's really about looking after the place and making sure there's an adequate and properly trained workforce to do it. These guys have got to be trained to get their coxswain certificates to be able to go into these waters, look after the water. They've had a very, very long relationship with looking after turtles in that country, for example. So helicopters are used, vessels are used, vehicles are used, and these people are responsible for doing it. It's really very important work for the conservation of Australian seas. Again, I want to congratulate Dhimurru for having the guts to have a go at it. And I want to thank my colleague, Tony Burke, and the other people who are involved in this decision, including in his department, for making this happen. In the Northern Territory, on land, there is an effective veto over Aboriginal land. But on water, there isn't, because the Land Rights Act doesn't extend to those waters. But it's about collaboration. It's about getting agreements with those people with an interest around how those waters should be used and maintained and managed. I have no problem with that happening because I know of the capacity of this organisation to do that work, and I know that people of goodwill will always get the best result.
Thank you. Because we started very long. We started for 20 years, and this is the vision and the moment what my people have been waiting for, because the people will see who we are. And we are not animals, we are people that will stand for our land forever. Thank you.